I'm hoping to introduce to you how to use your TI-30 calculator to perform exponents and radicals, which are also called roots. Okay. You have two different ways to enter exponents into your calculator. The first way is using just your squared button. It's sitting right next to your 7 key. This takes a number and automatically multiplies it by itself. Although sometimes that squared key isn't enough, you have to take higher exponents. That's what this does. It looks like an arrowhead. All that's telling the calculator is that you're superscripting or creating an exponent other than 2. Let me demonstrate. Let's take 29 and square it. We're going to use the 2 and the 9, and then we press our squared key. See how that little 2 shows up? That's letting the calculator know you want to take 29 times itself. Press the equal button, and your answer is 841. Now, if you want to take a number like 7 to the 5th power, we'll press the 7 key and then our caret button. The name of this button isn't just exponent, it's caret. I don't know why. So 7 to the 5th power is 16,807. Man, I'm glad I didn't have to do that by hand. The biggest thing to remember using your exponents is understanding what part of your base you're dealing with. The most important example that I can think of is something like a negative 5 squared versus the opposite of 5 squared. This is a huge distinction in math because in this example, the negative is part of your base. So that means what I really want to do is multiply the two negative 5s together. Your calculator makes this distinction also. So we'll start with the parentheses button. Negative 5, close the parentheses, and then square it. This answer is a positive 25. However, this expression stands for the opposite of whatever 5 is squared. So we enter the numbers without parentheses. Your calculator is smart enough to know the difference. Not all calculators know that. The answer to this expression is a negative 25. That's huge to remember. Specifically, let's say we have some substitution to do. 3x squared plus 4. We want to substitute a negative 6 in for this x. The translation then for our calculator is the parentheses. So we'll go 3, parentheses, negative 6, parentheses, squared, plus 4. Your calculator covers all of that for you. Your answer is 112. What's really awesome about this caret key, you can actually enter fractional exponents using your caret key and your fraction button. Let me show you. 64 to the 2/3 power. 6, 4, caret key, that's our exponent. 2, fraction key, 3. Again, what this means is 64 taken to the 2/3 power. We press equal, and we get 16. Negative exponents are a little bit trickier. Let's take 64 to the negative 2/3 power. Okay, 64 taken to the negative 2/3 power. Ooh, we get a fraction, or we get a decimal. We don't want a decimal for our answer. We want a fraction. We can use our calculator to convert this decimal to a fractional equivalent. We use this command right here, fraction to decimal, decimal to fraction. We'll press the second key, and this button will confirm we really want to convert this, and we get 1 over 16. Pretty awesome. Okay, now I do want to warn you, not all decimals flip over to fractions. So be aware of that. You can find roots of numbers. You can find the square root of 25. The square root command is sitting right above your squared command. So if you want to find the square root of 25, you'll press the second key and your squared button. Look at the parentheses. Okay, I'll come back to that in a moment. Okay, 25, close your parentheses and press equal. The square root of 25 is 5. Okay, now let's do something really cool. Let's say you have an expression. You want to actually take the square root of 12 squared minus 5 squared. That's where the parentheses are going to come in really awesome. Okay. We've submitted our square root. Now we're going to take 12 squared minus 5 squared, close the parentheses, and press enter. This answer is approximately 10.91. How efficient is that? Oh, that's amazing. Okay. You can find roots other than square roots. Above your caret key, you have an X root button. That allows you to find roots other than square roots. Let's say we want to take the 4th root of 152. You enter this expression exactly as you see it. You want the 4th root. So you tell your calculator 4. Press the second button and your caret key. That little X right there, that says that the 4 will replace that X, so that's how your calculator knows to take the 4th root of 152. That equivalent is 3.51. Okay. Now, there aren't parentheses here automatically. You can insert them if you wish to. So we can take, if we wanted to, the 4th root of 152 plus 7 squared. The 4th root, parentheses, 152 plus 7 squared, close the parentheses, and our answer is about 3.77. Okay. I hope this helps make some of your calculations easier for radicals and exponents. If you're not sure how to use your calculator or you need further help, please ask your instructor.